Welcome back, student. Today we are back again with a new chapter, that is lesson number 13 of standard 7, that is motion and time. Yes, exactly, the motion, the types of the motion you have already studied in your standard 6. The types of motion that you very well know, that there are different types of motions that are there, like circular, rectilinear, then periodic motion, rotational motion. But little bit more ahead we will study in these topics. What are these? Let us start now. There is a need to understand what do you mean by motion. If anything is moving and it displays with respect to time, if it changes its position with respect to time, that object is said to be in motion. Okay, so here it is actually the change in position of an object with time. And I said different types of motions are there. Likewise, motion along a straight line, that means rectilinear motion. If a car is moving in a straight track, in a straight line, or the athletes are running in a straight track and the march past of the soldiers, that type of motion is rectilinear motion because they are moving in a straight line. Then periodic motion, the motion of a pendulum. As you can see over here, this motion of the pendulum is a, yes, the periodic motion, and this is also known as oscillatory motion. Then circular motion, when an object is moving in a circular path. Don't get confused in circular and rotational motion. Rotation, if anything is moving at its own axis, that is rotational motion. If it is moving in a circular path, that is like just like here, then it will be a circular motion. Yes, exactly. Then speed. What do you mean by speed? Speed is the distance traveled within a given period of time. How much distance is traveled by a vehicle, any object in the given time period. From there, you can calculate the speed of any vehicle. So here, the distance covered by an object in a unit time is the speed of the object. If a car covers, for example, 100 kilometer distance it covers in 1 hour, then you have to calculate the speed. So you will put the value of distance here. Speed formula is total distance covered upon total time taken. Now here, the types of motion are uniform motion and non-uniform. If any object is moving equal distance with equal interval of time, that means the constant time is constant, distance is constant, then that is uniform motion. And non-uniform motion, if it varies, just like when you start your vehicle, initially it is at zero speed. As you start it, as it accelerates, you increase the speed, okay? And after that, if you apply the brakes, then suddenly there is a lowering down of the speed. So this type of motion is non-uniform because it is not moving with a constant speed. So these are the two types of motion. Next we have here the uniform motion and non-uniform motion. Just look at here, 0 to 1 and then 1 to 2. The difference is equal. And here the 10 kilometers, every 1 hour difference, the 10 kilometer distance is covered by this vehicle. So this type of motion is uniform because it is equal intervals. And in this case, your graph will be straight line graph. And our other sign, non-uniform motion, as you can see, initially the 20 kilometers was the distance. And in the 1 hour, next 5 kilometers, next 5 kilometers is next charge. With equal interval of time, but there is a variation in the distance covered by this vehicle. So you will get this type of graph, and such type of motion is known as uniform motion. And in this case, speed is not constant, but in uniform, there is a constant speed. These are the DT time graph, that is distance time graph, which is very important concept of this chapter. Here, if such type of graph is shown to you, if it is asked to you, what is in this case, what type of speed? Here the speed is zero. The object is stationary. It is not moving because it is parallel to the time axis. And here, this you already done, uniform motion, straight line graph, equal distance is covered in equal interval of time. And in curved line graph, unequal distance is covered in equal intervals of time. As you can see, slowly it is getting increased. There is an increase in the non-uniform motion. And on this side, you can see this is a unequal distance is covered in equal interval of time, there is a decrease in the non-uniform speed. So these are the dt time graph, which depends on the distance and time covered by the object, whether it is in equal interval of time, distance is equal or not. Next we have the time is used to measure by the clocks and watches, as you all know when you want to measure the time. So which way you will use? The watches and the clocks. For the measurement of time, we have different types of wall clocks, then table clock also, watches, some digital clocks also. So what is this here? Next, simple pendulum. Simple pendulum is, this was studied first by the Galileo Galilei. And what is this? Simple pendulum, it can be asked to you define simple pendulum. So you have to define it, that it is a small metallic bob which is suspended by a thread. And if the bob is taken to one side and then released to, it will move to and fro. This to and fro motion of the simple pendulum is known as periodic motion, because it is repeated in equal interval of time, and also known as oscillatory motion. What is oscillation? When bob moves from mean position, that is it moves from O to A and then to B and back to A. This is called a oscillation because it completes the one oscillation. If you count it from mean position, if you count it from the extreme position, then it should complete the one oscillation. So this is counted as the one oscillation. And time period, the time period of pendulum that will complete the one oscillation, that this oscillation, whether you count it from the mean position or extreme position, the time taken to complete one oscillation is known as time period of the pendulum. And length of pendulum is, that is taken from this suspension point to the center of the bob, that is known as the length of the pendulum. So here, if there is increase in the length of pendulum, length of pendulum, then the time will also increase. Time period will also increase with the increase of the length of pendulum. If it is a short length thread, then it will take less time to cover one oscillation. If it is long thread, it will take more time to complete one oscillation. This is an activity, so you have to just count it, the simple pendulum, the number of turns. So what you have to do is take a thread, hang it with the bob, metal ball. Then you have to take the time taken for 20 oscillations. First you have to take 20 oscillations, you have to count it, how much time it completes the 20 oscillations. Then how much time is taken by the next 20, then you have to calculate it. Units of time and speed. You all know basic unit is seconds, and then larger unit is minutes and hours, and basic unit of speed is meter per second, and larger unit is kilometer per second. If you have to measure the large distances of the, any, say for example in case of bus, any vehicle, that is bus, aeroplane, and in case of rockets, it is in seconds. And in ancient times, what are the devices to use to measure the time? These are the, this you can see, this is the sundial, and in this sundial what happens, the shadow of this angle will fall on the number, and then we will calculate what is the time exactly. And this is the again sand clock also and water clock. These are basically for the hour duration to count out. Then in ancient time, people, how they come to know, with the movement of the shape of the moon, they come to know about the, that this is 1 month, from one new moon to the full moon and then into the next. And natural periodic, that is I told you, full moon and the sunrise, full moon to the next full moon, that tells us the month. And the, with the one rise, sunrise to the next sunrise, that will tell us that it's a day. These are the different types of clocks: sand clock, water clock, sundial, and these are basically for the 1 hour duration if you want to calculate it. This is another thing, that is a wheel and the hair spring, that is in the watches, that how the needles in the watch, it moves. It's also depend on the simple pendulum principle. Okay, so this repeats in equal interval of time, that's why it's used here. And quartz, hard mineral, that consists of silica. This is used because regular oscillation of tiny quartz crystal, these are used for measuring the time accurately. And quartz clock and quartz watches, even the electronic clocks and watches are there to measure the time. Then non-digital and digital, in which the numbers are coming, and the needles that are non-digital. Non-digital watches that were used in traditional, and nowadays in modern era, the digital clocks are there that they display time also in digits. These use the electric cell for their working. Measurement of speed, I told you, this is one of the example. For example, it is given to you 100 kilometer distance. Time is 2 hours. So you will put the numerical figure in this. The speed will be 50 kilometer per hour. Now, if the speed of car and the time, then we have to find the distance covered by it. That means your speed is given and time is given. Then you have to calculate distance. So the formula will be S into T. And if you want to calculate the time, then distance upon speed. So these are the, then speedometer, this is, you all have seen on the dashboard in your vehicle, there are two types of these numbering systems are there. One is speedometer, which will tell you the speed of the vehicle, at what speed your vehicle is, you are driving. Then odometer, that will give you the measurement of distance. This is the odometer, which give you the measurement of distance, that how much distance is covered by your vehicle. This is a DT time graph, as I talked to you before about this. This is for the uniform motion. How you have to draw it? You have to take the equal intervals on the graph paper. That is the time on x-axis and on y-axis the distance. Then 0, you will count 0 point here. 0 for x-axis and y-axis here. Let me show you again. As you can see, the next reading is 1. So you will take the point 1 from x-axis here and y-axis here. The point is here. Simultaneously, you point the different and dotted line to mark the intersection of the two, x and y. Now you will put the straight line on the graph. This will give you. And from this graph, what you conclude can be asked to you in exam. That is, it states constant speed, moving at regular interval and uniform motion. Types of graphs, these are three types of graphs, the bar graph, pie graph and the line. Bar graph, in which this rectangular shapes you are making for representing the each one individual data, that is the bar graph. And pie graph, in which circular form, as in case of air composition. And the line graph, in which you plot a line. So motion of object can be represented pictorial also, that is DT time graph. That is very important as per your concept of the exam point of view. So these three graphs you have to draw, and you have to tell that this is the constant speed, uniform motion, this is increasing speed, non-uniform motion, and this side, the third one, that is stationary at rest. Speed is zero in this case. So this is all about our assignments of all this chapter number 13 of motion in time, and I hope it is understood to you. And we'll come back soon with more amazing fact of other few videos. Thank you.